Linh xin mời quý vị theo dõi ngay sau đây chuyên mục Cuộc sống thông minh, và trong chuỗi chủ đề vai trò của khoáng magie trong phòng bệnh và trị liệu thì chúng tôi sẽ trò chuyện với vị khách mời ngay sau đây được nội dung hết sức quan trọng, đó là khoáng magie có thể giúp thải độc tố trong bệnh nhân bị ung thư. Và chúng tôi xin giới thiệu vị khách mời của chương trình ngày hôm nay, đó là tiến sĩ dinh dưỡng Darren Starkey đến từ công ty Trace Mineral Research. Now thank you Dr. Starkey for coming here and continue to share with us some very useful information. Now we know that magnesium can help detoxicate a lot of bad things in a cancer patient. How does it work?
So what we have to understand is that these chemo or radiation can affect so many other parts of our body because of the cells. It's kind of a shotgun approach, but what we've discovered and what the mounting evidence shows is that this cisplatin can decrease, and what we're seeing in patients is up to 90% of their magnesium is gone. So it's so important that we reestablish that magnesium, especially the ionic magnesium, because oftentimes we don't have the ability to digest properly. Our body's been under attack. So with the ionic magnesium, it doesn't have to be absorbed.
You're right about that, but most of the Vietnamese people, even they don't know about that kind of thing and the importance of magnesium. When they are diagnosed with cancer, they would just concentrate on medication. And statistically, right, patients that have gone through chemotherapy, only about 30% of them could survive after that. Is that because all of the good cells have been already destroyed by the process, the chemo process, and they don't have enough magnesium to kind of build up new cells?
I think it begins with our diets to begin with. When we really stop to think about it, no one wants to be diagnosed with cancer to begin with, right?
Yes.
But we're such a reactive society around the world, not just here in Vietnam and not just in the States, but around the world. Our diets to begin with are very, very poor, causing our bodies to be very, very acidic, which puts a precursor to a lot of these different health concerns. So with that magnesium, again, a lot of it, of course, I believe wasn't existing in their diets to begin with. And so it puts us at a higher risk. You know, the minute that DNA or RNA changes in the body, and think about this too. Every cell in the human body needs magnesium to function. And when you really think about it from a cellular standpoint, we have 37.2 trillion cells in our bodies. At this point, remember this. Inside one human cell, there are more components than stars in the galaxy that you can see at night. Pretty overwhelming, right?
Yes.
In this case, we don't have to understand all the intricate details of what's going on because science still doesn't understand the potential of one human cell. What we do understand is that by hydrating and putting that magnesium, that ionic magnesium back in, along with that spectrum of trace minerals, helps put that foundation, helps that body detoxify, helps build back the good and protect it from the bad. And to me, it's all a basic principle of good nutrition. It should have been there before, but in this case, we have to reestablish it.
Yeah, true. It's very, very important because many cancers now can be treated, right? But patients have to be aware of the nutrition that they are taking in during the treatment process so that they can increase their chances for live longer after their chemotherapy. But for cancer patients, they also have to be on a lot of medication as well.
Yes.
So if we if they take more of magnesium, ionic magnesium, is there any reaction with other drugs?
That's a great question. No, that's really a good question because I don't know of any oncologist that states to their cancer patients, quit eating all fruits and vegetables, nuts, seeds and grains, quit drinking your water. You know, they don't do that.
Yeah.
So in this case, we have to remember that's what that ionic magnesium is, very much like that food group that we have consistency with every single day. So what we have to understand is oftentimes when these patients are going through chemo or radiation, they lose their appetite. Many of them start vomiting. They can't keep a lot down. So it's important to understand with the ionic magnesium, it doesn't have to go through a digestive process. It's, you know, because it's an ionic state. And again, that definition is an atom or a group of atoms that carry a positive and negative charge. So in other words, it disassociates very easily. It doesn't have to go through a digestive process. And we can get it back in us and establish it because that magnesium helps build that pure energy in the body, that ATP. It helps those molecules, those storage bays in our body, so we can reestablish our energy, we can reestablish that foundation, and more importantly, we can start the healing process again.
I think that all of your knowledge and your information even can save lives. Thank you very much for coming here and joining FBNC. Thanks a lot.
Thank you for having me.